Huh? Aqui? Não. This is quality. This is what quality innovation. This person has decided to make shoe quality that put to their pocket. It's mobile. And with this now, every person wants to get it. Just anywhere you are, you can brush your shoe around your friend. It's innovation. Somebody has decided to turn the shoe quality into something like this. Don't you like it? Huh? So they pack it beside. Reforming. Adding value, changing the shape, and part of innovation. This is an object that explains the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. Innovation. Instead of explaining God, vision, and all the things in the Bible, explain this. How is it? Man in darkness, separated from God. God is light. Okay? He came, just like we are celebrating this time. Don't you see it? Okay? Then, on the grave. Rose. To bring man back. Let me explain. Innovation. Now God is welcoming man. Innovation. Explain the whole big concept in a very short, simple, in a new way. This is innovation. Are you saying? So this person can be in the market. This object can be sold. So innovation can come in different form, in different ways. Don't you like that?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
So we are looking at one of the most important subjects in the course of innovation. Very, very important subject. Why is it important? Somebody came to my house this morning, an elderly man, for a discussion. He asked me a question, and that question also got me thinking. He said, where is that central table that is glassy? Because they have seen it. But as he came into it, he didn't see the central table. And he was supposed to ask, where is that central table? I told him I have discarded it. He turned it on. Do you know why it was thrown away? Eh? Just one simple, one small break in one of the legs. The table is for people like this one. So one crack in one of the legs makes that table to be not useful. That's for the hand leg, four legs. So as far as one leg is cracked, not functional, it cannot stand. You understand that? Maybe I can go take it for mending, but I felt taking this thing is not useful. Let me use this card. Just one. In the same way, maybe you have a tear rubber bed, bottle, tear rubber, tube. But if one tire of the bed, that tube, has a problem, what happened to that bed? Hello, madam. What happened to that bed? One tire is having a problem.
Vehicle
will be immobilized. Vehicle will be immobilized. You just use the right way. Nothing you can do to move that vehicle. Let me tell you, many people in life have been immobilized. You know why? Because they have not been able to balance the four dimensions of life. You have four dimensions, four legs that keeps you proper. And here we are going to see where innovation comes from. The spiritual dimension, you go to church, you spend all the time praying, fasting, you are developing that. Which is good. Which is good. Then the mental dimension, the where most people are lacking in life. The greatest missing dimension is how to develop the mental capacity, the mental dimension. And that is where creativity, innovation come from. The brain, the PFC, that's how we are looking at. The PFC, organ of innovation. Without developing the brain, which is called the mind, you are finished. You are immobilized. And that's why you see people go to church, year in and year out, graduates, no master holder, PhD holder. Nothing is happening. Because the secret of the brain, the mental capacity, has not been discovered and developed. The physical dimension has to do with your physical body and your health. The time goes on. Some of you are already taking alkaline water. Take it this morning. If I wake up in the morning, I take a cup of it. Tonight, I take a cup of it. Eat food, eat healthy, body. That is good. Eat well, take aeration, take oxygen, do exercise, travel, keep it in the physical body, then the financial. Because the mental capacity has not been developed. The financial mind is also wobbling. You know what is wobbling? When your tire is depleted, no air, you are moving. So many people are wobbling in life. In business, because there's something missing. And that's the greatest secret, apart from God. What we want to discover is the PFC, the organ of innovation. Until you discover the PFC and use it, be a welder, be a fashion designer, be a caterer, whatever people, nothing can come out that can make you to have the break to break in. So people are just managing to live. A lot of businesses, they start, they close. Very, very few people in life are actually discovered the use of the PFC. That's why the scientists, philosophers, all this here, they have told us that no human being, listen to me, no human being, whoever you are, whether you're a pastor, professor, whoever you are, you cannot develop and make impact higher and the development of your brain. So you see graduates or graduates coming out from the universities, and you see dogs. And they sit up and sit up. You come out from the university, keep going about, looking for a job, struggling, of course. The dimension that can make a difference, the PhD has not actually discovered. That is why we are told repeatedly that only 2% of people make things to happen. Why 98% are just holding hands and watching and just wondering what is happening? The 2% of people, they have discovered the PFC. The PFC is prefrontal cortex. Can we say it together?
Prefrontal
cortex. You will get it in the book. I wrote it about it in the book. And also, we gave you the handout. This lecture is good for 2 times. So I have not handled the handout today. After the second class of our program. If you look at the world, both in the biblical time and our contemporary times, very, very few people, they are means. They are renowned. Are renowned. Have you ever wondered about that? Yeah? Very, very few people came out clear, and people can still remember them, even though they are there, some of them, people can still remember them. Very, very few people. Then what happened to the billions of people? Do you know how many people are in the world right now? As we are talking.
8 billion.
Huh?
8 billion.
Yes, close to 8 billion. 7.8, precisely. 7.8 billion people. And out of that, we have women. 5.6 or so, women, 5.8 Billion. Yes. That's what men. And two men are 2.2 billion. Out of these billions of people, very, very few names are there. Have you ever wondered about that? Why is it so? Names like Isaac Newton, Abraham Lincoln, Martin Luther, Nelson Mandela, Benjamin Franklin, Julius Caesar, George Washington, Galileo Galilei, Gladstone, Lord Kelvin, Thomas Edison, Henry Ford, Charles Bouvier, and people like Paul J. Mayer. Paul J. Mayer was the youngest millionaire at the age of 21. Celebrated and some of these people are inventors, innovators, entrepreneurs, artists, statesmen, really sound politicians, but very, very few. Have you wondered why? Is it few? Why are they few? The difference is the use of the mental capacity, the PFC. It is only those that have discovered it and used it are the one that makes the difference in the world. All other people are ordinary. Listen to me. All other people are what? Ordinary. But these few are extraordinary. They are called genius. They are called geniuses. They have made extraordinary impact. So everybody has a name. Their names are like children. Somebody once came to me, said, Dr. Obi, I came to study that. Stay with you for 3 days. I said, why? Because from this locality, you are now a household name, worldwide global personality, through innovation. I said, what is the secret? What is the secret? I simply told you, the secret is God and the use of the PFC. What did I say?
God and the use of the PFC.
Scientists have found out, philosophers, psychologists, that until you or any man discover and use the PFC, the person remains the level of an animal. Right? That is strong. It's strong. That is the fact. So that is why you see a multitude of people through the church, through the program, support program, they remain the same. Because they have never discovered it. They have not been told. Or somehow they have never struggled to discover it. You know, Daniel, some people say, if I ask you now, some of us are Christians. So what is the secret of Daniel in the Bible, for instance? Taking our ability. If you read part of the story of Daniel, the Bible says he had a keen brain, a keen mind. That is the PFC. He discovered it. Coupled with prayer, with God, he was able to make the God of it. Joseph, the same thing. By Job, most of these great people, Jacob, very few of them. So, listen to me. All the lectures you can ever receive in this course, take this one as primary. Without it, not a word. Just listen to me. Without it. But when you discover the PFC and begin to use it, this is what I was discussing with somebody that the fish feed and producing, for instance, I've discovered another formula added to my formula which makes my own fish to taste like the water fish, the sea fish, the natural fish. To produce it like any other. artificial pressure, but there is something has discovered the part of my formula that make my fish to now make the fish to taste natural. And all the ingredients you need, they have it. That was asking me how. The how is a question of the use of the PFC. Ideas will need to flow. New ideas, and that's what keeps people in business. I told you. So, are you ready to discover this wonder? I say, are you ready to discover this wonder?
Yeah.
Now, the human brain, for instance, we have been told it is called the soul. Another word for it is the soul, and it's your mind, the main center. See, I have you. Sir, if you consider this center, what does it mean? Three face of man. What are they?
Body, spirit, soul.
Spirit, soul,
body.
This is how to discover the mind. The spirit, which is the innermost part of man, is there, and the spirit that connects God. The soul is the mind, is the brain. Are you understanding? The soul is the mind, the brain is the greatest secret, and I want to repeat, for you to the power of life and for you to create, to innovate, is the greatest power that God has put within every human being. Why is simply why the white people in Western world is growing? And I told you we have 250 years. For instance, look at the product of the brain. Can you name some product of the brain? Yes.
Facebook.
It's a product of the brain. The man does stuff. I want to make prayer. Okay, we are making prayer physical. Let's make it online. Faithful. And turn it to a blog. You don't know what is a blog. Come with that. And the man is making money. Every time you click on Facebook, you click on adverts, money is catching and sugar is catching in the adverts. And just make it great. Product of the brain, yes? Let me hear from this, my friend that is putting in hand. Yes. Instagram, okay, the social media, Instagram, okay, showcasing your products. Yes, more. That my brother has no email. Yeah, notebook, the light. It's a product of the brain, medicine. Notebook. Yes, more.
And the same we are using today, that is the same.
The same card, the mobile telecommunication, the telecom. It's a product of the brain. Yes.
Cell phone.
The biro.
The computer.
Hello? The biro. The cell phone. Yes.
Motor
car. It's a product of the brain. Yes. Huh? You wonder, have you ever entered an aeroplane? Huh? An aeroplane.
Yes, no.
Where you were? In an aeroplane, 45% of human beings use the creative part of the brain. 2 to 10%, while the rest, 90% of human beings, they use the animalistic brain. Does that make a meaning to you? Huh? So you should be ready to step up your brain. Is the organ for innovation. As a weather, you add the dimension of the PFC as a caterer, as fashion designer, or whatever trade you are learning, you add that dimension. You will see new design, new product coming out from you, and that is what keeps your business flourishing. With that, after some few years, they are running a business. And you can see examples, not only streets, see examples. Three shops in London. But I was passing one place this morning. There's a restaurant that I should like eat for some years and it has been closed. And I know that they were doing well, but today I don't know why they have closed. So when new concepts, new ideas are not introduced, business life, you become sort of fed up. So you have a passion, the same potential. But with the use of PFC, you can step up your business and take it to another level. So how does the brain work? The brain has a means to think. Your thinking pattern is generated from the brain, which is different from your feeling pattern, which is the function of your heart. When you fall in love, for instance, it's your heart. Feeling. Yes, when you like something. But when you are thinking, it's a portion of the brain. Not only thinking, the brain can generate both positive and negative thoughts. Both positive and negative thoughts. And I want to tell you, in our black world, in our African culture, we have so much of negative thoughts. How many of you know that witchcraft is a part, is a function of the brain? Witchcraft. Do you know that? It's black wisdom. That's what we call witchcraft. It's the brain. For doing evil, for negative things. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So the same brain can be stepped up for positive transformation, positive ideas. And that's where the white man beats the black man. Their brain, their witchcraft is for positive good things, good ideas, good products. But the black had to calculate and enjoy your neighbor. They had to kill. If that guy is going up, he's progressing. You do something to him. How to do kidnapping. Kidnapping. If that strength, no, that strength they give for kidnapping, if they use it for business, you know they can succeed.
Yes.
Because it's not easy for you to plan, go out, execute, and kidnap a whole human being. It's not easy. But because they have not been taught how to transform into positivity, they continue that level. Suicide bombing, for instance. Boko Haram and all this extremism. If they use those energy for positive, taking their brain to transform them to positive action. Wow. What do you think is that good? Listen to me. As we are talking right now, after some years, you are not going to be using your hand to press your phone.
Exactly.
When you are, what you talk is just look at it.
Yes.
Yes. The phone will work with your mind seeing. You don't need to press it. Sir, innovations. Your own will be, once you have it, just like fingerprints. So when you, like that, my friend, when you press it, I'll operate it. If I put my fingerprint here, it will go. Without my fingerprint, it will not work. New things are coming. New ways of doing it. So what is the product of the brain? Services of the brain. Content of the brain that are coming out. So we need to step up. And how many of you will be interested in knowing how to step up the brain?
I am.
Sir.
You are. You want to know how to the bread? You have a question? What is it?
Like, for example, when you have an idea and you don't know, like, something like you want to do something, you want to tell about it.
I told you of a woman, we are going to speak in the same conference in May, the Global Festival of Action, which is from Germany, first week of May. She is from India. She is called Mama Sola. Why is she called Mama Sola? Without any school, no technology training, but she built solar system. I'm teaching other women, leaders of women, how to build the solar business, how to build solar system. What do you call it? Who's the brain? When you have an idea, concept like that, depend one most on your brain. Take time to meditate. The how the inspiration will come. We are in a rush. We are in a rush. Our generation. We don't even know how to meditate. We don't have to meditate. When you meditate, the prayer will be giving you new inspiration. How to take that step, that idea, to the next step. That is one way. The second way, go and study. Go to the Google. Google has made everything simple. Google it. How to do this. Google will give you all the secrets. Study. Go to books, make references. So that books, for instance, when I got the inspiration about the floating fish, it was an inspiration. As I was thinking about it, I went to the problem. I went to the different sources and I saw that what I wanted, my estimate is really safe. I carried out laboratory tests, did a phytochemical analysis, quantitative analysis, proximity analysis. I discovered that that thing I had in mind is safe. Then I began to formulate. Last lecture, what was it? Who can remember last lecture? Don't look at the book. Turn your idea and innovation into business. So follow those steps. That answer the question. Is it clear?
I am.
I got the idea. The money may not be there. Okay, please, I have this thing I want to do. Wonderful. Can we partner together? Okay. Some partnership. Somebody like that is one of the things we suggested. We want finances. So, the factor of what we're talking about is the brain. The brain as a super engine. What do I call it?
Super engine.
Super engine is in every human being, and it's a private affair. No one can steal your brain. You have a duty. You wake up in the morning and say, I'm not in the mood. You are killing your brain. You are waiting for somebody to come and stir up your brain. No, you speak critically, you think creatively. Your thought pattern is your private. You can decide to have two minds, as we are here right now, for instance. Some people's minds are not here. You know what they are thinking? The fried Easter rice. Oh, some are thinking of school fees.
School
fees are all right. Yeah. So when you give it a positive thought, the brain will direct you. Through God, how to generate that school fees? Do you know you can make money as a student? No. I said, do you know you can make money as a student?
Yes, sir.
Some say no, some say yes. Well, I reserve that for one of the lectures. I'll be promising you, I can do that. Okay?
Yes.
How to become a social entrepreneur, how to become a digital entrepreneur. It's easy. With your smartphone, your smartphone you have is gold. It's money. It's bank. Your laptop. How many of you have laptops? You can imagine. Preach them how to use it for money. If you have to, we are going to teach you very soon. Maybe after this talk on the brain, that should be our last, next lecture. Because you must need to know the functional component of the brain. Before we know how to step it and step it up, the brain has some functional component. Number one, thought with functional component of the brain. Functional. The brain has the capacity to think, that is thought matter. Okay? It can think and generate ideas. There are over 10 million cells in the brain that generate ideas every day. So you can step up that use that pattern of thinking to bring up new pattern, new ideas. The brain also has the ability of memory. The memory aspect of the brain is able to receive, store, retain, and subsequently recall information. It's like the computer. Hello? You know the brain was developed from the computer was developed from the brain.
Yes.
So the computer gives it information. The computer processes information, stores information, processes it. And when you ask the computer, bring it out. So they bring it out. You know, one of the problems some of you are having, which I know, is how to remember some of these things you have been taught in the exam. How many of you are having that problem? You are thinking, how many people remember these things? Do I give you the formula? Which is part of the memory of the brain. The formula is simply M2OA. Through that formula, you can remember anything you have studied. You can pass any exam. What does that mean? M O. Number one, M one means memory aids. Memory aid. You know the use of memory aid. How many of you study physics? Yeah. How many of you? Number two, M means overlearning. Overlearning. O is two. Okay? Then A. So M means memory aid. O means overlearning. Second O means organized learning. And A means association. What do we mean by overlearning? If you want. Yes, M2O. So, overlearning means, hello, listen to me. Your books, for instance, read it again and again. By the time you are doing that, you are storing the information in the brain. When you are demanded, the brain will bring it out. But when you have not learned it properly, no amount of magic will bring it out on the brain. It's garbage in, garbage out. It is what you put in the brain that the brain will deliver. So overlearning helps you to what? Master it into the brain. Then, organized learning. Now listen to me. Anything you are learning, try to practice it from the... Hello, are you listening?
Yes.
Yeah. From the simpler to the complex. If you are reading your note, you're reading something for that matter. Start with what you know. Okay?
Yes.
The simple part of it. Then before you go to the complex aspect of it. By so doing, you are overlearning it. I give you an example of a driver that became a professor without going to school. A driver that became what?
A professor.
The driver was the driver that was carrying the scientific wizard, Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein was a professor of physics. He studied nature. He can describe the solar system, the earth, the water bodies, and the universe. So he used to invite him for lectures. So Albert Einstein would give the lectures from time to time. The driver would be there in the back, sitting and listening. So one of the days they were going to the meeting, the driver told Abel, he said, Prof, he said, Prof, I can deliver the letter to the administrator. The Prof was shocked. You mean this letter on solar system you can deliver? He said, yes. So the Prof removed his clothes and put it on the driver. And the Prof entered the driver's seat and drove down to the hall. And people were clapping. Ah, the Prof is here. Clap and welcome him. And he got to be dressed like a professor. He took his big books and stepped up. I said, Prof, it's your time to read the letter. And the driver came up, talking about the solar system, talking about nature, talking about the universe, and he was describing it as Albert Einstein used to describe it. At the end, they were clapping, back, back, Prof, 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 Prof. Great question and answer time. Throw one question and answer. We throw another one. It was thrown on balance. From there, they now wanted that Professor Albert Einstein to come up. From there, they knew that it was a guy. Can you see that? That is the power of overlearning. Overlearning. He was always there listening and learning. So that repetition made him to be a master of the subject. There is an incident that happened in one of the universities in Nigeria. You need to know this. There was a particular course. In that course, you can't pass it. Except maybe you grab the way. Anyhow. Because the diagram was complex. And it's always compulsory. That question is what? Compulsory. And it is an engineering course. The diagram, you take you round. So there's no way you can pass it. But some poor students, serious students, they say we are not going to talk about it. So what they did, they drew the diagram in the paper. When they are in the kitchen, telling their ignorance, they are saying it based on the word. When they are sleeping in their bed, the places of the word, they are saying it. When they are in the toilet, pooing, it's on the wall. Everywhere they just placed the diagram, and the brain was capturing it. During an examination, they gave them 1 hour. Before 45 minutes, three of them were done. They mastered the diagram and they gave it, they finished it. The lecturer was angry. He said, this cannot happen. This poor student, they did the examination manual. He cannot believe. So they took the matter up, said, I've caused for you. They did. So the student authority called them. They said, well, the student said, we are Christian students, we cannot compromise. So we stopped it. They said, no, you cannot get this thing like this. So the guy said, okay, for us to prove that you can do it, come back with the example. They brought four of them to the big hall, bigger than this mountain. One person in the corner there, one person in the other corner there, another one there, another one, and there were 10 invigilators. Professors, lecturers, specialists, they were there. And the students, back. If at this time around, they spend less time. Before 40 minutes, they have run the through and they pass their scripts. By the time they mark the paper, they discover that the people did it better than the first time. Is somebody understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
That's the power of brain. That's the power of over learning, organized learning. You can master any of this subject. Listen to me. What you are studying here, you can master it and become a genius through the use of the brain, through the ability of the mind. Is it clear now?
Yes.
Then you must also associate. You must associate when you are studying a difficult subject. If you want the brain to capture it very fast, you associate it with what you know already. You just picture what they are doing, that they are talking similar to that thing. The brain will easily capture it. That is about the memory part of the brain. The brain is also imaginative. imagine. You can imagine yourself to any height. The power of imagination. The brain can imagine any future for you. Whatever the brain of a man, the mind of a man can conceive, listen, it can be achieved. Yes. Just dream it, sir. Just imagine it. With the power of the brain, you can capture anything, you can achieve anything. But when you don't use the power of imagination, you cannot be inspired to achieve. Or when your imagination is negative, it's low, it's small, you achieve small things. But imagine yourself being the next solution in your own chosen field. I say imagine yourself what? Being the next solution the world is looking for. The world is looking for. It's very possible. Next also, another characteristic of the brain is consciousness. The brain is conscious. That is the ability of the brain to perceive in a silent manner. Okay? Then the brain is also elastic. Hello? This is what the brain is elastic, which means it can be stretched, it can be developed. There's a man, the wisest man in the world, Dr. Primas. He has over 50 doctorate degrees. Studied. He's an engineer. He's a philosopher. He's a physicist. He's a medical doctor. He's a geologist. Over 50 degrees. He's the wisest man in the world. He has developed his brain. Countries carry him like egg, like gold. When they have difficulty, things to solve. They carry the friends to now solve. Just to bring ideas, suggestions. Are you understanding? So you can develop your brain to that extent that you become relevant to every human situation. Today I'm an innovator, I'm an evangelist, I'm a writer, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm an inventor with a patent right. All these things about God's to me and the power of the brain. You can become anything you want to be through the elasticity of the brain. The brain is also imaginative, as I said before. Now, the last step, which is very key to this lecture, is how to step up and harness the power of the brain. We are not going to talk about that. Somebody understand me? From what you have learned today, you need to think. I said, let if I have your email, some of you will have this lecture in your sub email. Those who have the book, some part of the lecture are in the book. But when we come next, we're not going to see the steps. I've outlined here some basic steps which I have researched and discovered that you can do on a daily basis. If you don't do them, your brain relaxes back to the animal level. That is what can be discovered. Is somebody understanding?
Yes.
So many people in the world are in the animalistic brain level. That's why they cannot make